The Buddha's wife's story has not been told. The Buddha's story has been told for 2,500 years. It is told on the day of his first and only son's birth, he left his young wife sleeping. And this is called the great going forth of the Buddha. And about 10 years ago, I began to really wonder, well, what happened? What was it like when the Buddha's wife woke up and found him gone? And so we began to imagine her story.
There were only about five, quote, facts that are known about her life. And so we had free rein to develop the story as a novella. And, you know, I think we both believe in the power of stories to help people and to touch people where they live. And so the book is a wonderful amalgam of, first of all, the story, and then a commentary on the story about how this path was taken by her.
What really captivated me about the story of this woman was how did she go from being a traumatized, abandoned, grieving wife to becoming one of the women in the community who allegedly, when asking the Buddha if they could become nuns and join the life of the Buddha's community as nuns, the Buddha said no twice. And so the women on their own left home, shaved their heads, and walked hundreds of miles to where the Buddha was encamped. And when they got there, the Buddha's attendant said, well, sir, will we accept the women? And the Buddha started to think about it, and Ananda's attendant said, they're already here.
The second part of the book is looking at the steps of that path and seeing how this path of helping each other and taking action in community is in fact arising in our time and being validated in our time in things like Alcoholics Anonymous and other 12-step programs, the ecology movement, circle practice.
But this path really is a path of turning towards others, holding the relationship, which can become a vehicle of mindfulness, of awakening together.